Choosing the right keycap is critical when designing a keyboard. They define not just how your keyboard looks, but also how it feels to type every single word. However, when it comes to keycaps, there is an overwhelming amount of acronyms and terms. ABS, PBT, PC, Laser-Etched, Double Shot, Pad Print, those refer to how a keycap is made, and it matters a lot. The material and the manufacturing technique of a keycap directly affect appearance, feel, sound, cost, and durability. So it's essential to choose wisely. Let's start with the material. Although keycaps can be made of rubber, metal, ceramic, or even wood, most are made of plastic, typically ABS, PC, or PBT. ABS stands for acrylonitrile butadiene styrene. I said that in the first take. It's smooth, easy to mold, easy to paint, and naturally translucent, though you can make it in any color. ABS often gets a bad reputation because it's used in cheap keyboards, but you'll also find it in $200 premium keycap sets. It all depends on the manufacturing method, which we'll get to in a minute. PC or polycarbonate is less common. It's similar to ABS, but clearer and stronger. However, it's also more expensive and slightly more complicated to manufacture, so fewer keyboards use it. PBT, or polybutylene terephthalate, is harder and more heat resistant. It has a slightly textured matte finish that resists shine. That's why so many keyboard enthusiasts love it. It keeps its texture and appearance almost forever. On the other hand, it's trickier to manufacture. Colors are not as bright as on ABS, and it's opaque. This will become relevant when selecting manufacturing techniques. So, those are the materials, but that's only half the story. The real magic lies in how the legends are created. Keycap manufacturing methods. Pad printing. A silicone pad transfers ink from an engraved plate to the keycap. This is cheap and flexible. You can use a simple plastic injection mold to create the keycaps, typically made from opaque ABS, and then add the desired legends on top. Pad printing can be applied to any surface color, allowing you to have light legends on dark keycaps. However, pad printing has a few drawbacks. For example, the keycaps are opaque, so no light shines through. Also, the legends don't look as sharp. They feel like a decal. And most critically, they wear off very easily. These keycaps are typically used in budget office keyboards and laptops, but you can also find them in more expensive keyboards. A different solution is to use a UV printer that sprays ink directly onto the keycap and cures it instantly with UV light. This is an extremely fast and flexible method that allows for full color graphics and crisper legends. But the surface print can wear off with heavy use, and the keycaps and legends are still opaque. If you want light to shine through your legends, one solution is laser etching. First, you create a transparent ABS or PC keycap using a simple plastic injection mold. Then, you paint the whole keycap with the desired color. Finally, a laser removes the paint where the legends should be, revealing the transparent plastic underneath. This technique allows light to shine through the legends, making it ideal for keyboards with RGB lighting. It's also relatively simple and allows for any legend to be etched on the keycap while using the same mold. The problem with laser etching is that over time, the paint becomes shiny and, depending on the quality of the coating, it can even wear off. If you want to avoid that, you need double shot keycaps. This technique uses two plastic injections, one for the legend and another for the body of the keycap. That's why it's also called double injection. If you use translucent ABS for the legend, you achieve that beautiful shine-through effect. The result is legends that never fade, because they are literally part of the keycap. Typically, double shot keycaps are made with PBT, as its texture is highly appreciated, but ABS is also used due to its more vibrant colors. However, not all double shot keycaps are made equal. There are other factors to consider, like the thickness of the walls or the quality of the legends. If you look closely at some shine through keycaps, you'll notice small supports inside letters like O or D. That's part of the double shot process. This manufacturing technique is the most expensive by far, as it requires two molds for each keycap, and the same mold cannot be used for different legends. For example, if you want to produce keycaps in other languages, you need a set of molds for each language. One way to avoid making numerous molds while still achieving nice textured PBT keycaps is to use Dye-Sublimation, commonly known as Dye-Sub. Here, you have the legends printed on a special paper with sublimation ink. Then, you place it on top of the keycaps, and heat transfers the dye into the keycap surface. The pigment penetrates the plastic, so the legend will never wear off. This is also an easier manufacturing process. You can use a simple mold for any legend that you want. However, there are a couple of drawbacks. Of course, the keycaps are fully opaque. No light can shine through the legend. And the legends have to be darker than the color of the keycap. If you want a light legend on a dark keycap, you need to use reverse dye sublimation, which is trickier. You have to dye the entire keycap, not just the legend. Bonus methods. Those are the most common manufacturing methods, but there are more, such as engraving or CNC milling, used on wood or metal keycaps, triple shot molding for dual color keycaps or legend, or water transfer printing, used for custom textures. Okay, so now you know the main techniques, but what keycaps do we use on our keyboards and why? When deciding on the keycaps to use in our keyboards, the Dygma Race 2 and the Dygma Defy, we faced a conundrum. On one hand, we wanted the nicest and most durable keycaps possible, which would be double shot PBT keycaps. On the other hand, we wanted the sharpest shine through legends and to offer keycaps in as many languages as possible. That's only viable with laser-etched keycaps, because double-shot molds are too expensive for a company making niche ergonomic keyboards. For the Dygma Race 2, which features a more standard staggered layout, we found a supplier with high-quality PBT double-shot keycaps and collaborated with them to create a small double-shot mold for our custom thumb cluster. However, those keycaps were only available in English, so for other languages such as Spanish, German, Nordic, or Dutch, we used laser etching keycaps. Over time, we've perfected those keycaps, adding a highly textured coating and switching from ABS to polycarbonate for greater durability. For the Dygma Defy, we faced a bigger challenge. Compared to a standard keyboard, the Defy has extra one-unit keycaps in the outer and inner columns. We couldn't find a double-shot PBT set that included those extra one-unit keycaps with legends that made sense. You don't really want a number pad 7 instead of tab. Again, as a small company making niche keyboards, creating our own molds wasn't feasible. It's not only very expensive, we are talking over 100k, but also very time consuming. So we opted for PC laser edge keycaps, which offered the best balance between quality and versatility. That said, a high-end keyboard deserves high-end PBT keycaps. This is something that you have requested for the Defy since day one, and we fully agree. Of course, our dream is still to make double shot PBT keycaps, and maybe one day we will. But in the meantime, we thought you deserved something special, something we've been working on for months. Today, we are proud to announce our new sub-dye PBT keycaps for the Dygma Defy. They are available in dark gray with black legends and in white with gray legends. This is a limited run production to gauge your feedback and make any necessary adjustments to the design. We've made only 300 in total, so head over to dygma.com/pbtkeycaps before they run out. Even though these keycaps don't have shine through legends, there are a few ways you might actually prefer them over double shot keycaps. For example, they are much thicker and heavier. A standard double shot keycap has a 1.1mm wall and weighs about 1.25 grams, while these new keycaps have a 1.8mm wall and weigh 1.65 grams. That results in a much nicer sound profile and a premium feel. it hasn't been an easy project. For example, we had to create a special mold for the thumb cluster, as the PC mold made the surface too smooth. Getting the legends perfect, both in color and alignment, took countless samples and adjustments. We believe it's been entirely worth the effort. The keycaps look fantastic on the keyboard and feel amazing to type on. We can't wait to hear your feedback, and if you like them, maybe we'll make more limited runs in new colors, or even for the race too. Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss our next video. Arrivederci!